Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the Bogey McSandtrap Career Mode series here in Rory McIlroy PGA Tour Golf on the Xbox One. Now, we took a day off yesterday. I know that pained some people, but it just didn't work out in my schedule to get this one out on the daily basis. Now, I never promised anyone this would be a daily basis video. It's worked out that way that we did 5-6 days in a row where it came out at 9:30 a.m. Central Time, because I had them ready and they were all set to go even when I went on vacation. So I know you've kind of come to expect it, and I'm glad you guys are pouring in the support for this series and continue to view it and like it. I know some of you are like, more baseball, less golf. Some of you are like, yeah, do two of these a day. Yeah, two a day are not feasible. I also feel like doing two a day is not a very good YouTube strategy, flooding your channel with too much of one thing in a day. I don't think that would really be helpful, but that's just personally what I think. But I'm glad that you guys that are following this series and do like it are very supportive of it. So here we go, teeing off the third round of the International Classic, and on the leaderboard, atop the leaderboard, is Bogey McSandtrap. He gets a Bo's big hit right there and is going to blast this one on the first hole. Yeah, I'm kind of using that here and there. I'm using it more sparingly as I go on. In this round, I don't think I used it a whole lot. So trying to approach the green here and get real close, and that's looking really good. Setting up really good for a birdie attempt. Yeah, he wants to stay atop this leaderboard. So to go 17 under, the birdie putt is going to go. He's now 17 under. Now, I know there's been some talk about the difficulty, and yes, I am winning this international challenge right now, and yes, it's seeming pretty easy, but hang on in this round, and we'll discuss it at the end of this round, because I got a few things to go over here. Let's just watch this round play out, and we'll talk about it. So that is a nice approach right there. Things are looking like he could roar out to this really good front nine, but no, look at that. He missed the birdie putt. That was pretty much a gimme, and he knows it. Not feeling good about missing that chance to go 18 under. He's going to have to settle for the par. Did that rattle Bogey McSandtrap a little bit? Well, maybe. We'll see. Rory McIlroy at 10 under there. You know, he could make a run today and make this really interesting, obviously going into the final round. So here's where things get a little interesting. I see on my meter there that was not a good swing, but I've had swings like that before that hit the fairway. That one did not hit the fairway. That hit the tall rough. Yeah, that's way out there. And so he's got a couple shots out of the rough that kept staying in the rough, and he finally gets on the green and still has a chance for par. All things considered, a pretty good deal here. So can he make the par putt? No. Pushes that to the right. He's going to have to settle for a bogey now, his namesake, on this hole. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe it's in his head a little bit, that putt he missed. He'll at least tap this one and take bogey, and he'll just have to move on. So he'll drop back down to 16. And yeah, this gives Rory a chance here. Rory and the rest of the field. Seeing Bogey struggling a little bit, and oh, is this going to make the green? Ooh, okay. That recovered a little bit. I thought maybe that was going into the gallery there, but no, it stays on the green. So a little bit of luck for Bogey on that shot. Could have continued off to the right. So for birdie, it's a longer putt, and okay, there is putting's back on track. He makes that one. And we'll go back to 17 under. So I don't think I actually made a comment about it, but at the very start of this video, I showed you. Some people said upgrade the clubs, showing you what was in the bag. They are upgraded. I think I'm running with a Megalodon series where a lot of my clubs, but it was optimized out for what I should use. So it was a little bit of mix and match. So here's another real great setup for birdie. And all of a sudden, he looks like he's back on track, as he's dropped a couple shots now to 18 under again. Rory playing well. He's 11 under. He's going to try to put the pressure on there for sure. Another birdie attempt on 7, lining this up from 11 feet. And nope. Just misread that one. He's going to have to settle for par on 7. So a very up and down round so far. Not having the killer front nine that he did the day before, where he raced out to this lead. It's been a little bit up and down, but he's at 18 under still here, so obviously he's got some breathing room. Rory drops a shot down to 10 under, so we got a par 3 right here, and that's not looking good. Like I said, You know, I've had swings that didn't look straight, like that one right there you see down on your lower left, but yeah, I rarely end up in bunkers, and that one, well, that was one of his poor tee shots to date. Does save himself getting out of the bunker right there and onto the green. He'll definitely take that for a recovery shot. And try to sink the par putt, but no, that's to the right. Just not reading these greens quite right today. He's had a couple nice putts, but he's had a few more frustrating ones than he has nice ones. So, again, his namesake, the bogey, he doesn't want to have too many of those in a round. Again, really up and down. Back down to 17. Look at Rory, though. Rory's dropping shots. The whole field having trouble today. Rory can't really take advantage of getting back into this. It's kind of surprising. Par putt right here. No. Missed that 1-2 on 11. Man, frustrating. All his chances to really distance himself here, and it's not happening. Although, like I said, the rest of the field, there's another bogey putt. How about that? Is that three bogeys on this round? That's kind of tough right there. He drops down to 16. Rory's got to make his charge here. Somebody's got to step up and put themselves right up on the leaderboard here with Bogey McSantrap, and they're not doing it. And yet they're still watching him kind of struggle with his tee shots here. He's going to be in the rough again. Ouch. Yeah, that was a really bad swing. I was not straight whatsoever there on that one, you could tell. Yeah, I mean, some might question Bogey's sobriety today. I mean, was he out having a few too many in the clubhouse after round two? I don't know. Maybe. Well, that's up for debate. I cannot speculate there. But he is very inconsistent today. Here's a par putt, and it's not a gimme, but he does get it. Okay. So he's feeling a little bit better about his putting after that one. He's at 16 under still. No one really wants to step up there. Rory, 9 under. He's kind of stayed there. He was at 10 or what was it, even 11 under at one point? But no, he's dropped back. Here's a birdie putt. Going to miss that one. So he leaves it wide open on the 13th still. Only going to be able to get a par there. Come on, Bogey. This is by far been his toughest round of the tournament, maybe his toughest round to date in this series. He's just very erratic and inconsistent. But I guess you expect that of a somewhat amateur, right? Still, I mean, he's got his PGA Tour card, but I mean, let's face it, he's still very much an amateur. Look at this putt, though. Then he comes out and brings something out like that and shows his flashes of brilliance, getting that birdie putt, putting him back up at 17. Still Rory not able to climb up that board. Waiting for him to make a charge. I really have been for 2 days now, thinking he'd really put the pressure on, put the screws to Bogey McSantrap. There's another one that he just cannot sink, and the frustration is setting in. It's going to be another bogey. I mean, look at this. Follow birdie, bogey, birdie, bogey. He's just been kind of giving it back all day long. Still at 16, but there's Rory and others still at 9 under. They're just not going to pressure him today, are they? I mean, he's just putting the pressure on himself. And, well, that one doesn't look like that's going to be in the fairway either. That's in the rough. Man, just easy shots that it's been for him to just get right down the middle of the fairway recently. And you see him not even putting the extra power boost on there. He's just having a rough time, and my aim, obviously, is not very good today. This one, wow, okay, I think I hit the wrong button there and fast-forwarded that one being right on the green. I guess it was okay, right on the edge of the green. And then, oh, it looks like he was going to get that one for birdie, but no, no. Oh, man. Is he ever frustrated right now? Just for par from 5 feet. Should be a tap-in, and he gets it. But he wanted that birdie. Not going to get it. Well, all right. Done. So how is he going to finish this off? What does he got? One hole left? Two hole left? What's he on here? Here we are, teeing off on 17. He's got two holes left. Par three. All right. Run it right to the green, but then put the brakes on. No. It's into the rough, past the green. No chance. That just kind of sums up his round right here. It's been a rough one. Those of you talking about the difficulty right now, oh, and then he almost holes out for birdie, but no, he's going to have an easy tap in for par. Almost recovered right there, big time. Could have used a little luck like that. You know, remember his eagle shot last round. He needed something like that to just kind of spark him and get him going, but he's sitting here at 16 under. He's just basically been playing even all day. Now on 18, he's got one more chance to finish up on a positive note going into the final round, and yeah, that's more what he's looking for. All right, he's very much within birdie position. Definitely would like to end this off with a birdie putt, and he'll get it. Okay, so at least he's got a positive note. Apparently he was a baton twirler at some point in the band there when he was in school, because that was a little interesting what he did just there. Someone was asking me, did I fill that second attribute bonus slot? And yes, I did, and I can't remember which one I went with. I'll have to include it in the next video because I just forgot to get it in this one. But we are set up now for the final round. 17 under, still in first. Maybe Rory can have a crazy final day and push him, but we'll see. Come on back for the final round. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Subscribe right here on YouTube to get daily videos from SGU, as well as frequent live streaming events. Give us a follow on Twitter for up-to-the-minute information on channel uploads. And last but not least, check out the SGU Facebook page. So what are you waiting for? Join in on the fun today!